I took level one in June 2013. Last summer I broke my ankle, so I got an extension on my POI, which was water drill. Today I'm going to be going over upwind sailing with my kids. We set up a nice windward lure. Why don't you show them? Ben, go below them. Yeah, right behind their stern. I gave a chalk talk on land, I'm about to show you that. But I have about probably 10 minutes of footage of me coaching on the water. So I hope you enjoy it, and thanks so much. It's a metaphor! Okay?
I hate metaphors.
Yeah, I know, they're confusing. It's a metaphor. So, what I'm going to do, alright, and this is our first drill. We're going to go out there, we're going to do something called a windward leeward, okay? I'm going to have a mark that's really upwind of another mark, okay? Upwind simply means closer to the wind than another mark, okay? And you guys are going to have to zigzag back and forth from the one that's away from the wind to get to the one towards the wind, okay? Where should our sails be the entire time we're going upwind? All the way in, good. Who can tell me what point of sail we'll be on while we're going downwind? A run, good. And where are our sails on a run?
Opposite sides.
Opposite sides, we could do wing on wing, but for the most part, they should be all the way out, right? Harbor now, okay? There are going to be some red marks out there set up for the race course. Casey, I want you to sit in the boat, okay? But Ben, you got to sit opposite. Ben, you have to... Okay, I'll go over there. Hey, head out on the harbor, okay, you guys?
Okay.
Sounds good?
Where's the wind coming from?
It's coming from the southwest, over there. Yeah! Head towards the red marks! Alright, so Nate, you gotta switch your jib, okay?
I found out that me and the
new Get out your jib. Casey, pull it in. Yeah, beautiful. Lexi, I want you to pull it in on the same side as the sail. Yeah, there we go. Good job. Now pull it through the cleat. You see how it's like through that? Yeah, perfect. Got it. I'm gonna set up our course over near there. So once you get close to it, start sailing towards me.
I'm a sleepwalking cheetah with a hat full of napalm. Runaway son of the nuclear aid bomb. I am the world's forgotten boy, the one who searches and destroys. Honey, gotta help me, please. Somebody gotta save my soul. Baby, death ain't for me. Oh, look out, honey, 'cause I'm using technology. In the theater.
So we're gonna put down these white marks because we already have some red marks down for the rest of the school is gonna be doing. That way they're, you know, distinguishable from another course.
Dude, blast me.
The one who's searching to destroy. And honey, I'm the world's forgotten boy. The one who's searching only to destroy. Hey! Hey!
Beautiful. Alright, so now to go tell them what's
going on. Ain't got time to make an apology.
Alright, so someone tell me which one's the windward mark. Well, Dylan, where's the wind coming from? So which one's closer to the wind? That one, right?
It does smell pretty bad. You're right, Lexi.
All right, so I want you guys going around the marks this way. Okay? Well, it looks like Casey has the mark on his centerboard. Casey, you want to pull up your centerboard for a second?
Never mind. It dropped.
Alright, just start sailing towards the other white mark, you guys. I'm gonna move this one back into place. Have to be a little louder if I was downwind of them. So I'm gonna be yelling at them from upwind or just, you know, giving them instruction, I guess is the nice way to say it. Alright!
Hey, if I want to do wing on wing,
how
would I put it?
Gaffin.
If you wanted to do wing on wing, you do it when you're coming from that mark to this mark. You gotta put it outside that metal line right in front of your face. Alright. We're not using that one, okay? We're going up towards that white one and back down to this other white one. Okay? So, hey, Hannah, you wanna pull in your sail a little bit more? Right? We're going upwind, so it should be most of the way in, right? I also want you to head down a little bit. You're headed too high. Main sheet, right? So I want you to start using the main sheet. And hey, you guys in the front, is the jib in the middle or on one side or the other? Right now, is it in the middle?
Yeah.
Yeah, so it should be on one side, right? So Andrew, you gotta unclean it. Yeah, there you go. So we want to trim the jib on the same side of the main. Okay? Casey, you're pointed, you can't point right at the mark, right? So we gotta go one way or the other. Here's a trick I do, all right? If you make a V with your fingers like this, you can either go that way or that way. But the trick is the V has to be right into the wind.
Pat, watch out.
Good, so you just tack. Good switch of the jib, you two.
Are we going the right way?
Are you guys racing?
Yes.
Yes. Okay, the race mark is that red one over there. Guys in the front of boat number 14, you girls.
Yes.
Make sure that your jib's always on the same side as your mainsail, okay? Great. 17th racing wheel now.
Sheet a little bit more. Casey, you're headed a little too high. Okay, so you gotta head that way a little bit more, right? You're too close to the wind, so your sails are luffing a little bit. Whatever. Hannah, Lexi, I want you guys to let out your sails because you're going downwind, okay? Yeah, wonderful. The wind shift a little bit, okay? So I want you guys to just start heading back upwind when you get over to where it is now. Did they just turn around without going around the mark? Alright, we'll check that. Man, you gotta go around the mark, okay?
Okay!
Pull in your sails a little bit more. Let go of your sheet, right? Yeah, good job. Okay, so pull. Okay, you're tacking. Good. All right, so I want you to let off on your sail, okay, Andrew? You see how you've got like slack on this side? Andrew, just let yours go. Cam, you can let the one on Andrew's side of the boat go. Now pull on yours a little bit tighter. Now Casey, I need you to pull in on the mainsail. Okay. Switching. Let out your sails, girls! Don't hit 17! All right, good job avoiding. That was fine. Okay, so next time, you're gonna just wanna go this way instead of towards them. All right? So I need you to let go of that jib sheet over there, okay? Good. And I need you to pull in the main sheet a little more, okay? And Andrew, I want you to sit up on the side when he's up on the side. Cool. Yeah, that looks great, you guys. Awesome. little more complicated with three people in the boat. I was worried about the amount of wind out here today, which was one of the problems that we've run into earlier in the week. It's been a bit gusty out here. I think the wind direction is helping today. You know, it's giving us a lot calmer water where we've had 3 or 4 foot waves earlier in the week. And it's been pretty consistently blowing about 12. But today I think they probably could have handled it with 2. But I didn't really get a good read on it because I didn't know how, you know, the new skippers would handle their sailing. So just for your notice, these are 1 week old sailors. Most of them haven't sailed before. Earlier in the week, we covered parts of the boat. We covered some steering things. We went over what tacking and jobbing was. And we covered, you know, what jobs they should sort of be doing. The oddball part of it is that when there are three people in the boat, we'll either have two of them do one jib sheet, or we'll have the third one do the main sheet just to make the skipper get better at driving. But I'm really sort of impressed on how these kids are handling the concept of zigzagging upwind. They got the points of sail a lot quicker than a lot of other classes I've had. So it's pretty good. On a plus note, we're going to try and get them racing today. I introduced them to the concept of starts during the chalk talk. And Friday, normally we do a race day where everybody races in the camp. And you can see that's going on down there. But I think that's about it. I went over mark set. I went over rigging with the kids a number of times. We had them race to rig a boat and race to de-rig a boat. And we did that a couple of days when we couldn't get any, you know, kids out on the water. But on a better note, I'm gonna go watch my kids now because that big boat is gonna make some tough waves for them to handle. So have a great summer. Thanks for level one, and I hope you like the video.
Ambassador, a sweet talking night walking game.